If you started dancing salsa on one and you're now trying to dance salsa on two, try to avoid this very common mistake that I see is the most common mistake. I will tell you what it is and how you can avoid it, as well as some extra tools that you can practice to prevent yourself from making this mistake over and over again. When I go social dancing, or when I hear students talking about their journey about switching from dancing on one to onto, especially students who are in my classes and they tell me that they started dancing on one and now they're trying to take classes with me on two, the most common mistake that I see is that they don't hold enough the pause that we do on the number three and the number seven when we step our basic on two. So I will imitate the basic with my palms right here. Imagine that I am doing the basic on two in Shine's timing, right? So it would be like this: 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. What would happen usually is that people who are used to dancing on one will be used to going stepping strong on the outside steps, right? That for when we dance on two are on the two and on the six. They will be used to trying to step those numbers on the strong beats, right? That are 1, 3, 5, and 7. So usually what will happen is when you're trying to transition from dancing from on one to on two is that since they are accustomed to doing that break step on the 4 beat numbers, right? 1, 3, 5, and 7, they will usually speed up as they're doing footwork. Usually happens when you're doing your turns, right? So imagine that you're doing a right turn. What I would see that is very common is that you step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you leave no pause between each step and you default to going 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So what you want to do is be very intentional on the steps number three and number seven and make sure that you use up 2 beats in these steps. What do I mean? That you go 1 beat on each step on the 1, 2. But now on the three, we're gonna use 2 beats on this number. We're gonna step on the three, we're gonna hold the four, and then we're gonna continue stepping until the number five. So we basically use 2 beats in one step, right? Then we step on the five, step on the six. Now on the seven, we're gonna step again, but we're gonna hold again 2 beats on this number seven. So we're gonna hold the number seven and number eight until we go back to our basic on the 1, 2, 3. So basically, the most common mistake is speeding up on the timing until you get back to your habit of stepping your break step on the core beat numbers. What you want to do is, again, be very intentional when you step your number three and number seven. Make sure you hold out those 2 beats before you continue with your basic step. Now, one thing that I recommend is that you visit this website. I will leave the link in the description down below. It is called Salsa Beat Machine, and I recommend that you slow down the tempo because it's very much harder to practice these drills at a slow tempo because it will force you to be very much in control of your speed. So that's what we're aiming for, right? You go to this website, and what I want you to do is slow down the tempo to about 140 beats per minute, okay? I want you to select the cowbell and select the setting for it to sound on every single beat, right? And we're also gonna leave on the conga with the tumbao pattern so that it can help us throughout the basic. And basically, what I want you to listen to is when you do your basic, try to hold out your three and your seven with 2 hits of the cowbell, right? So on your one and your two, you're gonna use in each number 1 hit of the cowbell. And then on your number three, you want to listen to 2 hits of a cowbell before you step your next time. Yeah? So what do I mean? It will sound something like this. Okay? So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, double beat. You want to practice this alone in your bedroom, in your living room, as much as possible. And the slower you practice it, I promise you, the better you will get at this habit of dancing on two, which if you're trying to switch, I know it's very common that we tend to skip through those slow beats and speed up, eventually going back to your basic on one. So that's what you want to avoid. So I wish you found this very helpful. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this content, and leave a comment down below on what you would like to learn more about salsa. And I will see you next time. Bye.